Hello, my name is Mr. Fontenot. Welcome to my YouTube page, Mr. Fontenot 1111. Please like, share, and subscribe. In this video, I'll be calculating the inductive AC values from the Chapter 16 math handout, problem number 1. For more detailed description of the materials used in this video, please see description below. All right, for the test, you're going to have to know how to write out this new type of spreadsheet that we need for this circuit. You'll have to know how to write out this information right here from memory for the test. We're going to take our values from the Chapter 16 math handout number 1. We're going to fill in these blanks. So our VLT value is 24 volts. We're getting our inductive reactance values, our XL values from the circuit here. They're actually written on the circuit. And that's the only values you're given. The formulas we need from the Chapter 16 formula sheet, formulas 1 through 4, and formula number 15, I have clipped them from the formula sheet to put them on the screen to make it easier to see which formulas I'm using. All right, so we're going to begin by finding our XLT, which we see formula number 3 here tells us that to find our XLT, we need to add all of our XL values together. So 100 plus 120 plus 180 gives me 400 ohms. For my V, my I, and my X, I can use Ohm's law. So ILT would be equal to VLT divided by XLT. So I hit over under, I've got 24 volts divided by 400 ohms. And that gives me 60 milliamps. I see here that current in a series circuit stays the same in an inductive circuit, just like a resistive circuit. So I can go ahead and fill in all my current values. All right, now I can use Ohm's law to find the value of VL1. So VL1 is equal to IL1 times XL1. 60 milliamps times 100 gives me 6 volts for VL2. And the L stands for inductor. So the voltage through the second inductor is equal to 60 milliamps times 120 volts. 7.2. VL3 is equal to 60 milliamps times 180 ohms of inductive reactance, giving me 10.8. 10.8, 7.2, and 6 needs to add up to 24. Now we have to find the value of the inductors themselves using this formula, formula 15. So L is equal to XL over 2 pi F. So LT is going to be equal to XLT 400 over, we're going to do 2. To find pi, you hit shift exponent button, and it puts pi for you. Times my frequency. What is my frequency? 1.591 kilohertz. 1.591 times 10 to the third, giving me a total inductance value of 40.01 millihenries. For L1, I'm going to use XL1, so the only thing I change is my top number, 10 millihenries. For L2, I change it to my XL2 number, 12 millihenries. For my L3, change it out to 180, 18 millihenries. And as you see here, they should add up. 18 plus 12 plus 10 should add up to 40. All right, so the values I'm looking for that will go on your Chapter 16 math handout answer sheet assignment on Canvas are L3, XLT, and LT. So those values are VL3 is 6 volts, XLT is 400 ohms, and LT is 40.01 millihenries. Inductance is measured in henries. Thank you.